Void Mage Gamer is now partnered with Flipside Gaming. So you can use the promo code on their website, all caps, Void Mage, to get 10% off all orders, $10 or more. It's a great way that you can support both Flipside Gaming and Void Mage Gamer's channel.
Hello everyone, welcome back to another Top 10 Commander video. This time we're going to go over the brand new Commander 2019, something I've been excited for all year, and I enjoy what they did with this year's Commander products. They went with keyword abilities. It gives the decks a specific direction to go in, so you don't feel like you're just getting a bunch of good stuff in Commander. You're getting an actual strategy, which I thought was pretty cool. So we have four decks. We have the Morph deck, we have Flashback, Madness, and Populate, and a lot of decent options within those decks. But before I get into the top 10, I want to go over honorable mentions. I gotta show some love to these other cards too. Primacon Sky Rampart, I like the idea of a wall commander, and it's kind of a realistic wall because walls don't actually prevent people from attacking. It kind of prevents where they can attack. So you have to attack your neighbor instead of attacking me. If you're a neighbor behind the wall, then you can attack me. That's pretty cool. I like that flavor. Other than that, though, it doesn't do anything else, guys. So it's fun. It's kind of gimmicky. But if you want to build the ultimate Pillow Fort deck, this could be one of your commander options you explore. Chainer Nightmare Adept. I like getting Graveyard Recursion in black and red. Black and red has a difficult time with recovery. So you have a commander option here that's kind of like a Caridor Ghost Chieftain, letting you cast a creature card from your graveyard. You do have to discard. Pretty much you could discard a good creature and then you're able to cast it. So you're not really losing that much card advantage. However, it is kind of lackluster when you consider we already have a Caridor Ghost Chieftain. So it's not really offering anything new aside from the colors. The Haste is a nice addition though. And the Kadena Slinking Sorcerer, I'm actually really excited for this. I know she doesn't really do that much, but a solid engine for card draw, cost reduction, even if it's not super interactive, it's not complicated, maybe doesn't get the creative juices flowing, it's still pretty solid, and there are a lot of good morph creatures to choose from within Sultai. Garrett Conclave Exile, shouldn't really have to explain why. Populate is super simple. It's just, hey, look, I have a good token, let me make another token. And that's pretty much it. And then we have Volrath the Shapestealer. Doesn't really offer us anything new. We've had things like the Mimeoplasm, other shapeshifter creatures. If you want to make the ultimate shapeshifter deck, you could do that. It is pretty cool. You could interact with counters, I guess, but not one I'm personally excited for. So moving on to the top 10. Number 10 is Dockside Extortionist. Very efficient card. 2-mana red creature. Gonna see a ton of play in red, I imagine. Or token deck. Something like Brutaclad. Doesn't have to be the new populate strategy. It could be something that interacts with artifacts. But if you're looking at it as maybe possibly another Mana Geyser card, because keep in mind it is just 2 mana and you could net a ton of advantage off of this because your opponents are playing artifacts and enchantments likely in a 4-player game. It's not unrealistic at all to get 10 tokens off of this. Dump it into a burn spell. This is just a pure value card. I can't really see any reason why you wouldn't want to play it in red. And the number 9 is Orin Frostfang. Speaking of value cards, this is just another one of them, but in a different color, green. Attacking creatures you control have death touch. Your opponents are forced to decide whether or not they want to block and give up some creatures, and if you're able to hit them, you have a Coastal Piracy here in green, which isn't that common. It's something that Orin Viper did. They're not your typical green creatures, but the good thing about Orin Frostfang is that it's not just a snake. Throw it into literally any good green creature deck, and it's value, pure value. Number 8 is Rayami, First of the Fallen, probably my favorite Sultai legendary creature. Kadena and Volrath just don't really do enough for me. With Rayami, you can build your deck around good keywords and also good removal. Because your opponent's creature's dying, they'll also get exiled instead, so you get a little bit of aristocrat's hate there. You could just steal keywords, steal good abilities, kind of like Soul Flayer meets Odric Lunark Marshall. The basic idea here is to just make your commander as threatening as possible. But the cool thing here is that it's more permanent, so if you want to recast her over and over again, those creatures exiled will still be there, making her even more difficult to deal with every time you get her out. Number 7 is Anjay Falconwrath. Don't know the official pronunciation, so please bear with me. The Madness deck didn't really impress me too much with the legendary creatures, except for maybe one. Anjay just kind of meets par for me. However, I think that's still good enough to be within the top 10, because we're talking about Madness, something that doesn't really have that that much support pre-Commander 2019, so having a commander that specifically synergizes with Madness is perfect. And also drawing a card for the card that you discard helps you break even on that ability, so you're not losing a bunch of card advantage. So, kind of the same argument for Kadena, but I feel that Anjay fills a need, especially if we're talking about the lack of support for Madness. Number 6 is Bone Miser. If you like Waste Knot, this is pretty much like Waste Knot, but for your cards instead. It's funny too, because it's literally the creature on Waste Knot. So whenever you discard a creature card, you create a 2/2 black zombie creature token. Whenever you discard a land card, you get 2 black mana. And whenever you discard a non-creature non-land card, you draw a card. So a ton of value there, but this time focused around you discarding. And I don't think it would be such a bad idea to throw it into a lot of the same decks you're throwing Waste Knot into. It's a 5 mana creature, a little bit harder to get out there, a little bit more susceptible to removal as a creature, but still going to be somewhat of a value engine. I don't think you're going to be getting as much value compared to Waste Knot because that counts all of your opponent's cards, but still just a solid black creature with great triggered abilities. Number 5 is Aeon Engine. Probably the craziest card everyone's talking about from Commander 2019, and while I don't think it's going to be practical, you're going to pick on one player when you think about it, because you're reversing the turn order, which means you're going to go next probably. You're going to do this on the player who goes after you, so that you kind of get an extra turn, whereas the person who was supposed to go after them has to then wait another 2 turns before they get to take their next turn, which could be quite frustrating. Maybe not in the same exact way as Mindslaver, but you are still picking on one player, and reversing the turn order doesn't really change the game in any other way. So if you have to think about its actual purpose in the game, it's pretty much meant to get you a quick next turn. I think it's cool. I think a lot of people are probably going to want to play it. It has definitely gained a lot of attention. Number 4 is Savin the Chronoclasm. Really looking forward to this because if you're talking about focusing on the specific keywords, Savin's probably the best. Pretty much preventing all damage, so block all day. And copying spells can be quite ridiculous when you think about the flashbacks for certain spells. You have things like Increasing Devotion, so you could get 20 tokens. It just seems that copying the spells, while it's not super interesting, it does add an extra bit of firepower to an otherwise lackluster spell slinger deck. Because flashback is all over the place, you don't necessarily have a coherent strategy, so sometimes just getting an extra bit of value, getting twice the spells, is kind of cool. Number 3 is Elsha of the Infinite. I hope they knew what they were doing when they named her Elsha of the Infinite, because it seems that we have yet another good spell slinger strategy, non-creature spells matter strategy, whatever you want to call it. Being able to look at the top card of your library is spectacular. In fact, it's one of the most underrated things you can do in Commander. We've seen this with amazing cards like Bolas's Citadel. There's also Future Sight. We've seen this before. It's pretty powerful, especially if you can cast those cards. You have Prowess here, so if you want to build a deck around Voltron, trying to deal that 21 Commander damage, she may be one of the best options to go with from Commander 2019. She's probably better as the whole instants and sorceries matter commander, because you're going to be playing things like Kekar, you have Niv-Mizzet, Perun, in addition to other creatures with prowess, Monastery Mentor. We just have a ton of good cards that already do similar things whenever you cast a non-creature spell, but you have access to 3 colors instead of just 2, which we usually see this with an Izzet. So being able to combine those strategies with the other strategies of Kekar, I think is pretty cool, and she's already becoming one of the more popular options even before the actual release of Commander 2019. Maybe not something I would personally play, but a pretty good job here of combining pre-existing strategies. Doesn't synergize with flashback, so kind of a fail there, but overall a solid commander option. And then number 2, we have Kirik, Son of Yawgmoth, one of the most impressive cards we've seen from Commander 2019, and it's definitely high on my list, bringing back Phyrexian mana in a way that just functions as cost reduction for all of your black spells. Any cost with a black mana in it, replace that with 2 life, and suddenly you're cheating things into play at a rapid rate. Now, the only hindrance to this is running out of life, so play things such as Aetherflux Reservoir. You're going to lose life to play spells, but you're going to gain one for each spell you've cast that turn. In addition to something like Grey Merchant of Asphodel, there are a ton of ways to gain that life back. So you have yet another solid commander option, even though it doesn't synergize with any of the abilities of Commander 2019. You do have cost reduction for Madness, which it does function a alongside within the deck it came in, he is probably best when built around as a commander. You have a ton of cool things you could do. You could of course play with good stuff black cards, just making things like Runescar Demon cheaper, and you could also go for something like Tendrils of Agony to gain some life and possibly Storm. You do have the Aetherflux Reservoirs, Bolas's Citadel, ways to rapid fire play spells, gain a bunch of life. A lot of awesome interactions, all made easier with Kirik, Son of Yawgmoth. And then we have my pick for the number one card from Commander 2019, Atla Polini, Nest Tender. Now, a commander I wanted to play with long time ago when I first started playing the format was Mael of the Anima. I always had a difficult time building a deck because it's just big creature tribal, and her ability, while it could be good, you could cheat out a good creature, it has the possibility of whiffing. You could get nothing from it, and that sucked. With Atla Polini, you kind of fix those problems. You don't have to build a deck around big creature tribal, but just good creature tribal. Throw in really good creatures like Zakama, Godsire. They could be big, they could be small. You could throw a lot of good value creatures that are not necessarily big, and you're not likely to complain about getting any of them when your eggs die. And I talked about this in the spoiler video. You could get Birds of Paradise instead of a Zakama. I wouldn't complain at all. As long as you're filling your deck with value creatures, this is a solid commander, and it's interesting too. Populate wasn't necessarily an attractive keyword ability going into Commander 2019, but you have a solid token commander where getting more of these eggs can lead up to this crazy explosion, and you have this insane board presence getting one big creature after another. Supplementing this strategy with good sac outlets like Goblin Bombardment is essential. One of the more fun-looking commanders I've seen in a while, and it's my pick for the number one card out of Commander 2019. Anyway, guys, that's going to do it for this video. Let me know what you think about Commander 2019, my top 10 list. What cards are you looking forward to? You all have a wonderful day. Voidir signing off. See you all next video.